Hello there, first of all, let me show you an error I am receiving. When opening Visual Studio Code, I will show you how to fix it. Let's open Visual Studio Code. I got this error below, let me show you how to fix this first. Close Visual Studio Code. Go to this folder. I assume that you have already installed XAMPP. If not, then you can watch on one of my videos to install it. Link is in the description. Go inside the XAMPP folder. Go to the PHP folder. Copy the path to the PHP folder and Windows search to edit system environment variables. Open it and click environment variables button. In this window, go to the path, select path and open it, hit new path and paste the XAMPP PHP folder path we just copied. That's it, hit OK and close this windows. Now open Visual Studio Code again. And the error is gone, the error box doesn't ring anymore. Now to allow PHP debugging. We're going to do some arrangements. Assume that you have XAMPP installed, go to the XAMPP folder and start Apache server first. So XAMPP control, hit start in the actions column to start Apache server. So if it's green, the Apache server is start. Apache is all that you require for this tutorial. Now open a web browser. Type localhost, and if this page appears, it means that they started. You need to go to the PHP info page. So click the PHP info button. Now open this link in the web browser. Open this web and open the wizard PHP page. Copy all starting from the first line down to this line. Go to the page we opened and paste it and hit analyze my PHP info output. This is the file to download that matches my PHP info. The file must match your PHP information. Download the file, open it in the download folder and copy or cut it. And then paste it to this path. Go to XAMPP, find the ext folder in the XAMPP PHP folder and then paste it here. And we are done with that part. Open Visual Studio Code again. Need to add an extension, go to view extensions or hit Ctrl Shift X and search for PHP. We're going to install the PHP debug extension. So hit install. scroll down the details and copy these two lines. Actually, there are three lines. We need to enable remote debugging. Copy these lines, Ctrl C. Go to XAMPP PHP folder and find PHP configuration setting file or php.any file and edit it. Assume we are by the end of the file. So here, paste those lines. There is one more line we need to paste here. Go back to the web browser and go to the previous page and copy this line. And paste it below the previous lines we pasted in the PHP any file. We're all set, save and close the PHP any file. We need to restart the Apache server. So stop and start again from the XAMPP control panel. Go to Visual Studio Code again. Open the index.php file. As I said, I've already prepared a PHP file. I will show you where it is located. Folder is inside CXAMPP/htdocs folder, and the folder is my test app. You can name your app or folder as you want. So select the folder and hit select folder. I open that folder in Visual Studio Code, and there I have the file called index.php. Let me show you the folder in the Explorer again. Back to Visual Studio Code. To be able to debug, we need to add a breakpoint. I will add the breakpoint in line 5. Then go to this icon or hit Ctrl Shift D and go and start the debugging. To see debugging in place, go to browser and open PHP there. So localhost my test app / index.php. And you can see that the code has stopped in the line where I put the breakpoint. Check the local and you will see that the variable I is uninitialized. To step over, hit this icon or hit F10. And the variable value changes in the locals window. Step over again and the value of variable $i changes again. Over until this piece of code is finished. And now the index.php page is loaded in the browser. That is how you PHP debug in Visual Studio Code. And we are done here. Bye.